Welcome back to Phoenix Point, backers build number 4. This is Magic Flying Potato. So last episode, I lost everything. So, going to have to do another restart. See how well we do this time around. I lost all my guys. I did pick up a couple of recruits in the last few episodes, but I lost them. In the fight. And so this time we are starting inside the mist zone, inside Central America. This may be Mexico, Guatemala, Belize area, Panama, Costa Rica, Honduras, yeah, something up there. So what I am going to do is, before I drop my satellite dish, because that costs 200 materials to drop, I'm gonna go do some exploring first, and then I'll drop my satellite dish to see it, to expand this whole range of what I can see. I'm not gonna scavenge that slate just yet. I don't think we're going to find Mindfragger. So yeah, this looks like it's going to be another hard start for me. As we did start inside this mist zone, and one friendly, and we didn't find any more recruits. So let me go ahead and go through my recruits to make sure. I am going to try something different with them. Problem is if I lose this guy, I lose this. I don't know if I can make another one just yet. Manufacturer, what's the cost to manufacture one? Okay, so I'll make a backup before I give it to him. Okay, he's already worked with that. Training, shotgun proficiency, nope. Sniper rifle proficiency. Okay, so my assault guy that needs shotgun proficiency has sniper rifle proficiency, that word. Which I guess later on down the road, if I lose my scout snipers, then he can take over. I'm gonna give him a shot. Is that my only shotgun? Make a shotgun for reserve. So yeah, I'm trying a different loadout on these guys. I thought this was another 36, 31, 4, 20. Action cost 50%. Yeah, just keep his weapon that he has. Give him. What's it got? Give him another medkit, because. I give him two medkits. Nope, I won't. Training. Melee. No. My bumblebee looking guy. Mount it. See, now this will make sense because I think he does use the mounted weapons. We'll go ahead and train him in that. And I'm going to give him. Why would a medkit weigh that much? Alright, so he doesn't get a medkit. Alright, so I think that's it for my guys. Alright, so yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to go in and... Why can't I go in now? Do I have to fly out to go back in? Okay, where is... Is there an attack? Attack, attack, attack. No, I gotta fly out to fly back in. I think. We'll find out. Fly there. Oh, you know what? I screwed the pooch on this one, because I should have dropped my radar dish. Because I used my materials that I needed. I'm building weapons, and now I don't have a radar dish. Which hugely limits me to... I messed this one all up already to begin with. Should have just dropped the radar dish from the beginning. So I might have to... After this battle, I'll probably do another restart and drop the radar dish. Okay, so I want to check out this zone first. There's something. There's a crap guy right there. Resource right there. That resource. Okay, so I got two of them over here. Those are the ones I need to build a radar dish. So, those are the ones I really need to try to protect the most. It's a good thing there's a lot of them out here. Okay. Trying to one, there's two. There's a lot of crab dudes over here. Let's see what else I got going on. This guy doesn't move, and his jump jet capabilities usually are horrible. This guy right here this is like the best guy to have, because he has the best movement and he usually gets multiple shots with his weapons. I'm trying to figure out, I guess I'll move him over here to try to protect this one. I just exposed them to three. Okay, so I'll move. Before I actually start attacking, I'm gonna see where my other... I don't even know who this guy is. guy is. That guy right there. There, he won't have any fire points, but he will also be at a... Do I got somebody up here? Looks like I got another one up top, because that line going up there is like a line of sight for something. Kind of like over here, the red ones. That means I am in the line of sight to hit them, and they're in the line of sight to hit me. It turns blue. We're in the line of sight, but we got an object in the way. So if I do that, it looks like there is one up there. So this is a sniper, which they get... These guys get very little movement points. And if they're in the line of sight of somebody, that means they, if the crabmen move, I can be hit by them if they move into a better position. This jump jet guy. Heavies are nice, but he fails constantly when he tries to make a jump. As I will... So I'm going to try to make a jump up here, and I bet you he'll fumble. Every single time. I would say he fumbles, okay, not every single time. He fumbles more, like 90% of the time. I don't want to, this guy is so... wanted to get him out of the... He was in the path of everybody. Three of these crabmen, which they would have lit his ass up. So this time around, I tried to get all my guys out of the initial drop zone. I didn't do any overwatching or anything on them. They hit those, it starts off with 20 resources, so every time they take it down, oh, he's gonna probably should throw a frag and get a bunch of my guys. So I already lost 20 resources. Yes. Shotgun to the face at point blank range. An alien in here. I don't know where he went to. Problem is, if I move him up there, he's in sight of three still. Guy's gonna bleed out, but I don't know how soon he's gonna bleed out. So I'll just help him bleed out. This guy lost his weapon. I don't know if he has a pistol on him. He does not. So, yeah, his weapon got destroyed by that grenade. Sniper doesn't have a shot at anybody where he's at. I don't know if he could get up to the top. No. Kind of exposed right here. That guy's supposedly bleeding out, so we'll see what happens. Let's see, who does he have a shot at? Okay. No, he does not have a shot at him. Okay. Let's see if I got a shot now. Shot at the guy that's bleeding out, but nothing over there, so I will overwatch. It says I got another movement. Oh, I got one movement point with him, and that really didn't do much. Is he serious frame drops. Serious frame drops going on right now. Putting that scout right there on the tower like that. And took the ladder out, so now I can't get up there. Now he's poisoned. It's like I don't want to wait. I know he's going to bleed out. But I don't know how long it takes for them to bleed out. My guys seem to bleed out awful quickly. Actually, not take the shot because he does have a shotgun. This guy is, I don't know what, he's kind of useless, unless he doesn't have any movement points. Fired twice at the other thing and then overwatched afterwards. I don't know how they work that. Can't throw my grenade anywhere. Let's see. I need to get off this. See if I can heal myself. Still poison though, but out of okay. Two. Can I throw a grenade at anything? Nope, no range. I'm out of sight. Weapon back up. Oh, now I'm back in sight. But I can't throw. Yeah, that probably wasn't a good move for him, but there's this guy. There's really him. I think that guy's pretty well protected in there. kidding me. What it is every this round, every time the aliens, it's like my computer starts to overdrive. I can hear my fans going. I don't know what's going on with this. And you can see the frame drops and lagging of it. So that guy got. Who did I just lose? Just lose a guy? Okay, so up here, shoot him in the face. Shoot him in the face with my shotgun. Shotgun's a badass weapon if you get up close to the guys. I need to get to my other. Problem is now he's completely exposed, and I have nowhere to go with him. No, I do have somewhere to go with him. Does he still move? Okay. I have nowhere to go with him. So it's his turn. I know there's a guy in here. There was a guy in there. He went to the shitter. Bumblebee guy, the heavy mech guy, pretty much my favorite one to use because he has the most capabilities with hit points, or not hit points, but just being able to move and fire. Once again, as soon as these aliens start, something's going on with my frames. Thank you. some of these areas do have supply drums that they can get to. I wonder if there's a supply thing up here. I can't get up there. Still poisoned. I don't know if I have another. I do not. I need to get somebody to him. Guess this guy. My scouts together. Not the smartest idea, but. I think this is the last alien right here. So I got to the blue zone and he got some willpower and stuff back, but I really don't know what that does for him. Okay, so his poison is done. So he's not gonna bleed out anymore, but that's not a good idea. Shotgun him in the face. Point blank range. Bitch. Alright, so did a lot better on this one. But the problem is I don't think I got enough loot to drop a radar dish. Didn't even think about that at the beginning. But I don't want to have my heavy weapons guy die and then lose that grenade launcher, because I don't think once I lose it. Oh, I might have enough to drop now. 200. I just got to get back to a friendly base, which would be fly back home and drop my radar dish. Alright, so I went ahead, did that, actually worked out good for me. My personnel are back in the main base. I think they are, being that we're back here, they're all ready, so they got their wounds healed. Next game, I will continue on this time. Try some different tactics, different weapons that I haven't used before. And I will also try to... I know I saw there was an APC last time around that I couldn't pick up because I needed these two slots. So I may leave one or two of these guys back home while I'm flying around. I don't like being in the mist zone because that means it's all these guys are a lot harder. But anyways, until the next mission, this is Magic Flying Potato playing Phoenix Point Backer Build Pre-Alpha number 4. A lot to say right there. I am out.